Good day everyone, my name is Alex and welcome to the most exciting TV box review that I've ever done. So I probably tested around 60-70 TV boxes, so a lot of TV boxes. To be totally honest, they do get kind of boring. It's the same thing over and over, nothing really changes. We can't even get Dolby Digital and DTS on 95% of them, so very disappointing. Well, today that changed. Today I'm actually excited to do a TV box review. Today I got a Zidoo X9S. So this box will be available in about 5 days, I believe. I will leave some links in the video's description if you want to check it out. Inside this box, we have an octa-core processor, 2 GB of RAM, 16 GB of internal storage, and running Android 6. So pretty exciting. Let's start by checking out the box and see what comes in it, and then let's check out the box. Let's begin. The X9S comes in this box right here. On the front of the box, we just see a picture of the TV box itself. Onto this side here, some information about it, and here onto the back, the specifications for the X9S. If we pull out this screen cover, so this comes out, we get to the real box. So this is the box that we get. On the front, we just see X9S, and here some more information about the box. And onto the back, we just have their website. So if you want to check out their website, that's their website. Inside the box, we find a very simple user manual. The user manual will show you how to use the box, how to connect the box to the TV, and so on. We also find a SATA cable, so you can connect the hard drive to the box with this cable. An HDMI cable. Next, we are going to find the power adapter for the TV box. And lastly, the remote control. This remote control takes 2 AAA batteries, and even though it looks like a nicer remote, I do recommend using a wireless keyboard and mouse with this TV box for a better experience. And the most important thing, the TV box. So the TV box is made out of metal entirely, so the front, the back, the sides, everything is made out of metal. On the front here we have a small LCD that will display the time, that is the IR sensor right there. Onto the front here we see some specifications about the box itself. On the right hand side of the box we have a SATA 3 connection, so you can connect a hard drive through a cable, which is really really cool. Aside from that, we see a USB 3 port right here and 2 USB 2 ports. And the back of the box, it's even more exciting. So starting to the left there we have the network adapter port, then we have a HDMI out and an HDMI in. And you're probably wondering why we have a HDMI in. So let's say you connect something else to the box and you want to record whatever it's on that other device. So onto this particular box you can actually record stuff from another device. So yes, you heard me correctly, you can even schedule the box to start recording at a certain time. So a very very cool feature, but I'll show you that later on in the review. Aside from that, we see the AV output, the optical output right there. We have a slot for a SD card, that's also the reset button, the power adapter port, and we have an on-off button. So you don't always have to turn off the box from here, you can just turn it off from the software. So you basically put it in like a sleeping mode, and this is if you're not gonna use the box for a while. Aside from that, we do have 2 external antennas. And lastly, on the back of the box, we have 4 rubber feet and some holes so the box doesn't overheat. As soon as we turn on the box, we get to their logo, and this is also their boot up animation. And in about 10 seconds, the box starts up. The first thing I notice is the fact that we have a navigation bar, and this is a very good thing because most TV boxes with Android 6 don't have this navigation bar anymore. So we can also swipe down so we can see any notifications that we may have. Let's start by going into the settings app. So the settings app has lots and lots of settings. I haven't seen this many settings ever. At Wi-Fi here, we can just connect to the Wi-Fi network, and this box supports dual Wi-Fi. That means that it can connect to the 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks. And since I'm here, let me show you the Wi-Fi speeds. Through a wired connection, we get a download speed of about 123. On the 5 GHz Wi-Fi network, we get a download speed of about 106. And on the 2.4 GHz network, we get a speed of about 44 for download. So very, very decent speeds for the Wi-Fi.
continuing on the settings app, so a display here, again, we have lots and lots of options. Here you can select the screen resolution, so you can choose any of these depending on your setup. It may be different depending what TV you actually have connected to that. At sounds and notifications, so here again we have lots and lots of options, more options that we know what to do with. So since I'm talking about sounds, I did test out DTS and Dolby Digital, and yes, DTS and Dolby Digital work very, very well. I haven't had any issues with either of them. At storage and USB here, I'm gonna show you the storage that we have available. So we have available about 9 gigs out of the 16. So yes, it seems that a lot of internal memory is being used by the operating system. However, you can install an SD card as internal memory. So that's exactly what I'm doing right now. So you press format as internal, and all of a sudden that SD card that you have installed into the box would become internal memory. And since we are talking about memory already, let me show you the speeds for the internal memory and the RAM. For the internal memory, we get a reading speed of about 89 and a writing speed of about 24, so not the absolute highest speeds. And this is also the speed that we get for the RAM. Continuing with the settings app, so at playback here, which is a new option, again we get some more options here, so depending what you're gonna use, you may turn on or off some of these. Moving back here at HDMI CEC, what this does, basically you can set the box to turn off whenever the TV turns off or turn back on, anything like that, depending on how you're planning to use the box, so very, very easy to use. Moving back here at languages, so these are gonna be all the languages available onto this particular TV box, so I'm just gonna scroll through them, hopefully you see the one that you are interested in. So a lot of languages here, and I'm still scrolling. So these are all the languages available onto this TV box. So many languages. Moving to about TV box. So it's running Android 6.0.1, and that's the model number, the X9S. And also the last security patch is coming from May 2016. And now we are back to the main launcher. So here we have a couple of options. The launcher doesn't have that many things that you can customize. However, we can change the location for the weather right here. We have a task killer as well. So if you press clean up, it's basically gonna kill all the apps running in the background. The app lock, it's a very cool thing. So if you set a code for this, and I've set 1, 2, 3, 4, so let me show you this. You press unlock, and then you can select any apps from here. So see, this one, it's locked, so if you want to open this app, you're gonna have to enter that password. So if you have any sensitive apps like Gmail or stuff like that that people shouldn't see, you can lock them with the password. Aside from that, we can just add other apps onto the main screen here. So if you want to add the speed test app, for example, you'd just press on it, and then all of a sudden you have the speed test app right there. Now let's see what apps come pre-installed on the X9S. So we get the Play Store, the first one, and then we have something called the HDMI in, and I'm gonna touch onto that a bit later, because you can actually record stuff onto this box from another device. Aside from that, we get Kodi. This is their Kodi right here, and this is version 16.1. We also have the remote control, so you can download an app onto your smartphone, and the box can be controlled from your smartphone. So it only works on Android devices at this particular time, but to get the app, you just scan that QR code right there. So aside from that, we see the Explorer here, the File Explorer, basically the YouTube app I actually installed myself, Miracast, which I'm gonna test a bit later, and that's about it. So we don't have that many apps pre-installed, but since we have the Play Store, and yes, I can confirm that the Play Store works very well, so you can download pretty much any apps from the Play Store, and the Play Store works without any issues whatsoever. On the Antutu benchmark, we get a score of about 36,000, and at info here, we can check out more information about the box itself. So, whatever processor we have, whatever RAM we have available, and so on. And I know that some of you are interested in knowing if the box has root access or not, so yes, this TV box has root access from the factory. Continuing with the Geekbench 4, we get a multi-core score of about 1518 and a single-core score of 548. This is some more information about the box, and down here we can see some more information about the test. I have to say that this score is rather low and I was expecting a much higher score. And for the last benchmark test that I'm gonna do, the iStorm Extreme, the score is 4612. And down here we can see some more information about the score. And the CPU Z-App will just confirm everything that we already know about the device. So I'm just gonna scroll through these. And here we can see the temperature for the processor at this particular time. I did see it as high as 85 degrees when I was playing a game a bit earlier. And since we are back to the main screen here, let me explain what this HDMI in is. So you've seen that the box has a secondary HDMI there. So basically you can plug in any device through HDMI cable and you can record whatever you'd see onto that device onto this TV box. So very, very cool feature. Right now I have another TV box connected, so I'm using the mouse to control the other TV box. It's actually another Zidu TV box, it's an older version. But basically you can see anything that you'd see onto that particular device and you can just record everything onto this one. So you even have the option for scheduling whenever the box should start recording. So if you have a show coming up or something like that and you wanna record it while you're not home, you can also do that. So very, very cool and very easy to do. I mean, you don't really have to do anything. It's right here, you just press a button. So very, very easy to do. The X9S comes pre-installed with Kodi 16.1. I have Kodi opened at this particular time. I'm gonna go to system info here and here I'll check out a couple of things just in case you guys are wondering. So this is all I have here. Now if I open the settings app here at the system, so let me press system. So these are this is everything that I've had set while I was playing DTS videos a bit earlier and Dolby Digital videos. So yeah, just so you guys have an idea what's available here. Let's check out the stream from Kodi. I'm sure it's gonna work absolutely fine. So we don't get any add-ons that come pre-installed on this. I actually installed this one myself. But they're very, very easy to install. So I'm just gonna open a random one. So let's try this one, for example. And let's try here. And let's see this one. And then let's see this one. So I'm just trying a random one so you can see how it does. So it does seem to do very, very good and I don't see why Kodi wouldn't work. Now I'm gonna quickly show you how multitasking works, because a lot of these boxes just close apps that run in the background. So let's say we have the Play Store right here and then we wanna switch to something else. So I wanna switch to the Antutu benchmark score. And then I want to switch to Kodi, for example. And again, I want to switch to something else. So let's see what else we have running here in the background. So I want to switch to the speed test. So everything seems to go okay in the background. Now it's time to check out some files. So I did try every single file from here and they all go very, very good, except for this one right here, this 10-bit at 1080p. This player cannot open it and I have to open it with the MX player. But let's start with the first 4K file. So this is a 4K file. Let's click on it. let's try again. So yeah, this one does go very, very good and very smooth. It's gonna ask me to restart, so we'll just restart that. And yeah, this file didn't work on any of the S912s or S905X. So it does work very, very good onto this TV box. The following one that I'm gonna try is this one, so another 4K file. This one also works excellent. So no issues with this one either. And as you can probably tell, it does do very, very good. The following file that I will be trying, it's another 4K file. So this one here, it's another 4K file. This one was filmed with my phone. And this one will also do extremely, extremely well. So no issues with any files that I've tried onto this particular TV box. The only file that I wasn't able to play with the player that comes with the TV box, it's this one right here. However, if we do open this in the MX player, it does seem to do very, very good. So I'm just gonna start it for a bit so you can see a piece of it. But yeah, all the files that I have tried with this box, they all do extremely, extremely well. So I haven't had any issues with any files whatsoever. Unfortunately, at this time I wasn't able to get Miracast to work, even though the device is being found onto the smartphone. So I see the device whenever I press connect to it and I accept it onto the screen here, the TV box disconnects from the Wi-Fi network. So this is most likely a bug and hopefully it will be fixed in a future update. I have the YouTube app opened. Let's check out the maximum resolution. I already know the maximum resolution. It's in fact 1080p. So you can see the quality right here at the bottom of the screen. And if I maximize this onto the screen, it does seem to go fairly smooth. I did see this video smoother on other devices, but overall I think YouTube seems to do very, very good. So no issues whatsoever with YouTube, and we can watch YouTube at 1080p. I'm currently playing FIFA 16. And yes, it does seem to work fairly good. I did play this on a couple of occasions. So let's see if I can... oh no. Yeah, I don't see too many games that wouldn't do that good onto this particular box. Oh no! And I missed. But yeah, FIFA 16 seems to do very, very good on the X9S. And it's time to conclude this video. So overall, I'm very, very happy with this box. This is the best TV box that I've tried. I'm happy to see that we have the navigation bar at the bottom of the screen. I do like this HDMI in feature. It's something that you don't really see every day. I don't know how many times I'm actually gonna use it, but there will be a time when I'll probably use it. The Wi-Fi seems to work extremely well on the 2.4 and the 5 GHz networks. I haven't had any issues with any apps aside from this one here. So as soon as you actually open it, it closes. So aside from that, I didn't find any apps from the Play Store that don't seem to work. Overall, the best TV box that I've tried. So if you guys have any questions, please leave a comment down below. If you did like the video, press that like button. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.